Maybe I should go. You could take it from here, right, Eric?
Are you kidding me? You are not leaving me here like this.
We definitely get to see the nitty-gritty and actually see how people are at their most vulnerable times.
My name is Stevie. I'll be your nurse. What brings you two in this fine evening?
There was a man on the bed who seemed a little bit uncomfortable to be there, and he had his wife at bedside, and she kind of seemed nervous and didn't really want to be there.
Any history of high blood pressure?
No.
They didn't really want to answer questions.
Diabetes?
No. Excuse me, it's Thai. Really spicy Thai food.
The emotion that the couple had was mostly embarrassment.
How about any allergies?
They got sick. I got a hold of a bad clam once.
Actually, Eric, you do. Remember that one time you took penicillin after Thailand? You had hives all over your...
All over my neck. It was very uncomfortable.
Okay.
Working in the ER is kind of like being an investigator.
So I understand you have a foreign body lodged somewhere. Did you accidentally swallow something? There's nothing to be ashamed of. Last night I had a girl in here lost half a Q-tip in her ear.
This is not that type of thing.
I was hearing a buzzing sound that just didn't quite sound right. It wasn't my phone vibrating. I kind of looked around for a minute.
Is that on my cell phone?
And the husband kind of looked at me like, you know, you kind of got me a little bit type thing.
You know what? If you don't tell him, I will. Eric lost my favorite. Oh, no. It's him. He's looking for us.
Don't answer it.
Hello? Oh, hi.
Don't tell him we're here. He can't know we're here.
I'm going to go take this in the hall. You need to tell the nurse what happened.
Maybe since it's just me and him, maybe he'll open up to me a little bit more.
So if you can just tell me exactly what happened, I can try to help you.
This is kind of embarrassing, but I have a really severe case of constipation.
Well, it says here that you're here for a foreign body.
Yeah, sure. But I was thinking maybe what I need is like a prescription strength laxative.
Laxative. Okay, just scoot back and let me take a listen.
Well, I listened to the lung sounds, and then I put my stethoscope on his stomach, and all I heard was a continuous buzz. And so that had to be the issue.
What is that?
Okay, don't worry, I took care of it.
He doesn't know we're here?
No, I refuse to tell him which ER we're at. He doesn't know.
And tell him why.
Oh, tell our son about this.
When we are involved in like family drama, it's really awkward.
I told him your back was going out.
You just don't know what to say. You don't want to interject into their personal business or anything.
Perhaps you two could use a moment alone.
I stepped out of the room and went to go get the doctor.
You will never believe what's going on in Bay 2.
What? What's that?
A very interesting patient.
Did you tell him? Did you tell him what happened?
No, I don't.
What are you doing?
I don't want to tell him.
Do you see yourself?
I just want it out.
Tell him.
The doctor walked in, introduced herself.
Hello, sir. I'm Dr. Roberts. What seems to be the problem?
She listened to the lung sound. And then she listened to his stomach.
So, Eric, can you tell me the source of the buzzing?
Told the nurse here I have a very severe case of constipation.
Oh, I see.
And she just told them that we'll get an x-ray and we'll figure out exactly, you know, what's going on and how to get it out. So the doctor and I were looking at the x-ray.
That is not constipation.
No, it's not.
We could see perfectly a large object that was lodged.
Oh my gosh.
It's worked its way pretty far up there. I mean, that's his large intestine.
You guys have to get that out of him. Our son is coming, and he's gonna go ballistic on us.
Once a month, we would see something a little bit bizarre. You know, people just do things they're not supposed to do.
He must have had a lot of lube.
This is the first time that I encountered a running vibrator still inside of somebody.
Is there something you'd like to tell me?
That's something that really needs immediate attention. It could lead to internal bleeding. It could lead to infection.
So what do we do now? Do we just wait for the batteries to run down?
What, are you crazy? We need to get this thing out of me now. I can't wait that long.
It could lead to major abdominal surgery.
Laxatives won't work, then how are we going to get this thing out of me? Huh?
It could lead to like colostomy bags, feeding tubes, things like that.
It would be helpful to know exactly how you managed to insert that so far up into your intestines.
Yeah, can we please not talk about it? You're making it worse.
But the husband, he wasn't really forthcoming with the information.
Oh, it's all my fault.
And so the wife finally told that they had been trying to be adventurous, and then they kind of used the vibrator. Things got out of control, and the vibrator got lost inside of him. Somebody got too excited or something. I don't know. I assisted the doctor with the procedure. You're kind of racing against the clock because you definitely have to retrieve it.
If we don't get that obstruction out, he's going to end up with a perforated bowel, colostomy, sepsis, or worse.
The doctor looked at it and she just said, pretty much, she was like, there's no way we're going to get this out.
Prep the OR, call the surgeon.
Whenever you come out of surgery and sedation, usually you kind of just give up what type of information you want to. It's kind of like a truth serum. So I knew the parents were pretty embarrassed.
Terry, might as well come clean. I don't hear any buzzing, it must be out.
Oh, poor dear. Your father's talking delirious. Hun, your back surgery was a success. Look who's here. Joey came all the way down from college to see you.
What are you talking about back surgery? I didn't have back surgery.
Other? Is there something you're not telling me?
No. You know how sedatives are. They make you say the craziest things.
That's a little bastard now.
It was the vibrator that they had extracted from the patient. Who wants to look at their parents as a sexual being ever?
Please do not explain. You were totally right. I shouldn't have come down here. I'm gonna go.
At this point, they just both kind of just don't even know how to look at each other, how to act around each other.
What I want to know is how did that get so far up into my gut?
Unfortunately, I'd say it's a mix between battery power and muscle power.
It was a combination of the vibrator still being on that definitely kind of shimmied its way up into his large intestines.
That's stuck.
I also think that is a reflux of your muscles. Your muscles are made to kind of push things and move things.
Oh my gosh!
And so his body was actually working the way it was supposed to, but not in his favor.
Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me?
I vote for no more adventurous sex. The old-fashioned ways are good enough for me.
Let's just keep electronics out of it from now on, okay?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh.